Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. You are welcome, you are welcome, you are welcome. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are welcome in the name of Jesus to this special day, the 19th day of our waiting upon the Lord. Hallelujah. Wow, 19th day of waiting upon the Lord. We want to thank God for His goodness. We want to thank God for His mercies, for all that He has been, and for all that He will continue to be. Amen. So, as you come in, settle down. Thank you, Jesus. May the name of the Lord be praised. May the name of the Lord be glorified. Hallelujah. 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 Wow. Congratulations to the Americans. Even as at now, the new president is still signing executive orders, reversing policies. What a president. What a way to hit the ground running. Our own is to hit the ground dreaming. Oh God, what a country. Today a president was sworn in and he is signing 37 executive orders already. A policy that does not favor the country, be reversed. Quick, before you. The country is not about an individual, it's about the people. Oh goodness, I wish Nigeria can learn. The country is not about tribalism or nepotism, it's about who is involved. Oh come on, I have been so glued to my set, watching everything, having a reminiscence, because I've been in the Capitol, I've been in the monuments, I've been in all those areas in Washington, I've been there. What a nostalgic feeling to see that, wow. Now what a thought to even begin to think that the Capitol Hill was the place that was being defied and desecrated by some, in quotes, hooligans. The Capitol is the pride of America. The American pride, the Capitol Hill. How dare? Where did you come from? How did you get there? But today, an executive order is being signed. Quick. Reversing policies, removing hooliganism. Oh, come on. I wish Nigeria will learn. Oh, Nigeria, my country. Our own, 1 year, ministers were never appointed. 1 year, going to 1 year, ministers were not appointed. Well, go and see how a country is governed. Anyway, kill that Goliath. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You are welcome. Oh, goodness. Somebody said, Father, carry us to the Capitol Hill. No, I will carry you to heaven, not be here. Yes, you are welcome in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Yes, I had a program in Washington. Myself, Father Mbaka, and some other, we had a program in Washington, and the hotel was lodged was not far from the Capitol Hill and the monument that is the heart of Washington. So I have to drive down. However, in 2006, I was in the Capitol Hill as well, because my senior brother stays in work in Washington. Yes, worked in Washington as the head of U.S. Department of Veteran Affairs. My senior brother is the head of U.S. Department of Veteran Affairs. So his office is opposite the White House. So when I came to the U.S., he took me to his office and we went to, you know, all those area in the U.S. I mean, in Washington. So I've been to that place. I know that place very well. I've been there for many times because my brother's office is opposite the White House, where he works as the head of U.S. Department of Veteran Affairs. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Hey! Hallelujah! We give God the glory. May His name be praised and His name be glorified. Let us just begin to thank God. I like today. Today is kill that Goliath. This today, thank you, Jesus. I have been so blessed this weeks of prayer. You see, we don't have much time. By this time next week, if I have 3 days time, the next 2 days we are done. Today is day 19 now. We are beginning day 19. You know, tomorrow is day 20. So 2 days time, we are done for 21 days. And I thank God for His goodness and mercies. I thank God for bringing us together to pray. Wow, to pray. Wow, thank you, Jesus. Is that Sado? Come on. Thank you, Abba Father. Prince says, okay, my DOS. Yes, I was a DOS. So who must this be now? My able DOS. So Prince says, Zua Ben Charles. Okay. able DOS. You are blessed in the name of Jesus. So we want to thank God for His goodness and mercy, the grace that have brought us together. I tell you, my spiritual life has improved. I never knew I would be between midnight, but my spiritual life has improved. My prayer life has improved. See, the schools is yet to be open, so I have time to pray. I thank you for helping me. Yes, I thank you for helping me. My prayer life has really improved this period. You know, so, but don't worry. We are not going to stay too long waiting. We only have like one week or so. Then we are coming back with 21 days festival. We are coming back with 21 days festival. Festival of what? Festival of favor. 2021, it will bless you. 2021, your story is changing. 2021, you are celebrating. 2021, God will give you something to show. 2021, you will have a testimony to tell. 2021, people will congratulate you. 2021, people will gather in your house for celebration. 2021, we have results. 2021, your heaven is going to open. 2021, you are going to wear the garment of favor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So, as soon as we are done with 21 days fasting and prayer, like a week, then we are coming back with the festival of favor. The festival of favor. The festival of favor. That one is to tear the heaven open and let favor reign. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I cannot wait for the festival of favor. It's the first time I am going to be doing that. And it's the first time, so we are doing festival of favor together. We are good. I have not done festival of favor before. So yourself and myself, we are going to be doing festival of favor the first time. So I cannot tell her it is, because we are doing it the very first time. So God will give you favor. This year, 2021, you are going to enjoy God's compassion that will open the door of favor for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So don't worry. We have a lot of activities lined up for this year. When we are done with 21 days festival of favor, then we are already in the heart of Lent. You know, we are already in the heart of Lent. When we are done with 21 day festival of favor, then we are going to now begin 21 days again, baptism of prayer. Now we begin on Easter Monday, 21 days baptism of prayer. Oh, come on. Anyway, just get ready. And God is going to bless you. And God is going to do for you what you cannot do for yourself. Amen. So as I said, my prayer life has really improved. I don't know of you though, but me, oh come on. Oh come on. I thank God for this experience. Prayer life improved, spiritual life improved. You know, and I'm so conscious. God may bless you. Amen. So today we are looking at day 18. Day 18 is about killing that Goliath who is bringing embarrassment. Killing that Goliath who is defiling the name of the Lord. Killing that Goliath who is reproaching your life, your family. What is reproaching your life? What is reproaching your family? Goliath reproached Israel. Goliath, you know, mock the God of Israel. But you see, God used David. God used David and removed Goliath. The head was removed, not just being killed by the sling, but his head was removed so that to be sure that yes, you are not there. When we confront Goliath, we are not gentle. Listen to me. When we confront Goliath, we are not gentle. When we confront Goliath, there is nothing like take it easy. When we confront Goliath, there is nothing like you just have to be careful. We whip out Goliath. Oh, come on. This is the vehemence that is required for the warfare against Goliath. Because Goliath will send fear and anxiety and hold you down. Goliath held Israel down. Everybody will be afraid. But you need to be voracious. You need to be aggressive. You need to be violent. If it is Goliath, there is nothing like take it easy. If it is Goliath, there is nothing like you are praying too loud. Pray in your heart. There's no pray in your heart about Goliath. You don't pamper Goliath. You hammer Goliath and remove it from the way. Oh, come on. You are not soft in dealing with Goliath. You cannot be philanthropist. You cannot be philanthropic in dealing with Goliath. You cannot be soft. If not, you will be down. Goliath will hold you down. Goliath will oppress you. Goliath will step on you. Goliath will press you down. You cannot be soft in dealing with Goliath. You cannot be gentle in dealing with Goliath. You cannot take the soft path in dealing with Goliath. David never took the soft path. He went into head to head. Goliath cursed him with his God. He replied Goliath. Anyone that is Goliath on your life, God will reply them. God will reply them. God will reply them. When Goliath began to curse David with his God, David cursed Goliath back. You don't keep quiet. You cannot be quiet when it comes to dealing with Goliath. You must be vehement. You must be violent. You must be tough. You must be hard. Because Goliath, oh, come on. You will be oppressed if care is not taken for generations. Even they want to come. But when David came in, he taught us how to handle Goliath. David taught us how to handle Goliath. When he heard of the reproach of Goliath, when David heard, he said, what is this? So you see, when it comes to Goliath, you don't take what others can take. You don't take it. Israel took the assault of Goliath, but not for David. David said, no, I cannot take this thing. I can't take it. How dare you reproach the name of the Lord? Who is this uncircumcised Philistines reproaching the name of the Lord? And everybody, we are afraid. Saul was afraid. Everybody were afraid. Nobody could come out because Goliath was a giant. What is the giant in your life that is making you afraid? What is the giant in your life? That what is the giant in your family that is keeping everybody down? What is the giant that when you think of it, your heart shudder? What is the giant? What is the obstacle? What is the impediment? What is the mountain? That is what Goliath represents. But you cannot be quiet. You cannot take it easy. You cannot be soft. And you cannot be gentle. When you are dealing with Goliath, you must be hard. You must be tough. You must be aggressive. You must be brutal. You must be terrible. Come on. David did not only kill Goliath, he cut off his head. He cut off his head. He said, Goliath, I have come to you. He said, you have come to me with sword, with shield, with javelin. He said, but I have come to you in the name of the Lord God of Israel. Today, I will kill you and I will cut off your head. I will give your body to the birds of the air and your body to the carcasses of the forest. Hey, he said, I will cut off your head. God does not give victory with javelin, with sword. God gives victory through, he said, God is the one that gives victory, not with sword, not with javelin. He said, but today I will kill you. And the whole world will know that there is God is in Israel. That is how to deal with Goliath, with audacity, with boldness. David approached Saul. He said, Saul, let no man's heart fail him. Let no man's heart fail him. How old was David? 17 years old boy. If you want to be popular, kill Goliath. You don't take it gentle, or you don't tread softly. You finish Goliath. I remember when there were Goliath around me. Oh, come on. When there were Goliath, I went into midnight. Makabare gado ligidibo suka. The Goliath against this, at least the Goliath against this ministry. There were some Goliath against this ministry. Hey, come on. There were some real Goliath. When I look back now, I just fold my hand. I say, God, I thank you. There were some Goliath who will not want me to drink water, who will not want me to raise my leg, who will not want me to do anything. There were some Goliath. There were some Goliath. Oh, there were some Goliath who fought this ministry. Who today, many are in the grave. How dare you? You don't dare this thing. Many are in the grave. Many are down with infirmity. I look at them as they look at you now. They thought you were a Goliath. You were fighting what was greater than you. You were fighting that had the backing of Yeshua. You were fighting the what? You were fighting what had the backing of Jehovah Eyon. You were fighting what had the backing of Jehovah Shekinu. You were fighting what was beyond you. But today, look at you. So when it comes to Goliath, you don't keep quiet. You fight. David fought. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Abba Father. Oh, come on. I still remember today. There was a Goliath in the life of my parishioner. A Goliath in the life of my parishioner. He wouldn't let the daughter be. He wouldn't let the daughter have peace. He wouldn't let the daughter succeed. He wouldn't let the daughter advance. He wouldn't let the daughter make progress. This Goliath was not an outsider. He was a father to the daughter until the daughter came. Let me share this testimony with you. Until the daughter came and said, "Father, man of God, help me. My life is not moving forward. Man of God, my life is not making headway. Man of God, don't leave me like this. Man of God, help me." I look at the lady's case. It was an obvious case of Goliath. I said, let us enter into 21 days. This was the book we use. We enter into 21 days. We began to pray. Makababo Shaka. I joined her in prayer. 21 days was not for me, but because of the condition of this woman, I enter into prayer for 21 days. When we got to day 19, I told her, "This day is kill that Goliath. So we are not going to relent. So we are not going to rest. So we prayed earnestly. This prayer point today, we are praying then. We prayed earnestly on day 19. On day 19, we pray with all our heart. That very night, I was in a vision. What vision? The Lord led me to the house of this lady, to their house in the village. The Lord took me there. When I got there, I was in their compound and I saw everybody moving around freely except this young lady. And I was telling this young lady in the vision, "Why are you now standing here? My friend, move. The young lady said, "Father Alfred, this is what I have been telling you. You can see now, I cannot move. Everybody were moving about free and fair. But this young lady was stagnated. This young lady was in one spot. This young lady was not moving forward. This young lady was just there. I was forcing her to move. I said, "My friend, move. You can move." She said, "I cannot move." It was in the vision. I cannot move. I said, "My friend, you can move. She said, "I cannot move." That was how I woke up from that vision. Immediately, I called her. I said, "The Lord led me to your village. I saw you in your family compound. Everybody were moving freely except you. Why won't you move freely? Why can't you move freely?" She was looking at me. I said, "Now, the meaning of that vision is that your problem is coming from your father's house. Your problem is coming not from outside. The reason why the Lord led me to your village, your problem is coming from your father's house. So God has shown me now where your problem is coming from. So let us pray further." And we pray this prayer. As we finish on the last day of our prayer, we celebrated Mass together. Then I told her, "From today, don't worry about your case anymore, because the Lord God is taking your case over." She said, "Father, I will do exactly as you have said." And so that was what happened. 2 weeks later, a call came from the village. "Oh, your father is sick. He is asking after you." And she came to meet me. I said, "My friend, let me pray about it. If the Lord give me a word, I will let you know." 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. Then I called her. I said, "My dear, you go nowhere. Don't go to that village." She said, "Father, I will do exactly as you have said." So 1 week after, the father was calling her. I said, "You go nowhere." She said, "I'm not going anywhere." I said, "Is your mother not there?" She said, "Yes." "Are your other brothers and sisters not there?" She said, "Yes." "So why are they not looking for you in particular? You go nowhere." So 1 week, she did not go. 2 weeks, she did not go. 3 weeks, she did not go. The more she refused to go, the more the father was emaciating, the father was reducing, the father was reducing, the father was reducing. Her destiny was being used before. Hey God, come on. Her destiny was being used before. Her destiny was being used. Her destiny was being used. Now the father was asking her to come so that there will be an exchange of life. This thing I'm telling you now happened live. So there will be an exchange of life. But the lady did not go. So what happened to the father? The father got ready one day and said, take me to Benin. I will go and see her myself. Take me to Benin. Take me to Benin. And they put the father in the vehicle and they were driving her down. The daughter here did not know that the father was coming. The father was only looking for a way to set his eyes on the daughter. If I can set my eyes on her, I will live, but she will die. Because the destiny of the daughter, the first daughter of the family was being used by the father. That was the covenant. You will sacrifice the destiny of your daughter. You will sacrifice her destiny. So that was what was used. And so the father was desperate because things have turned around in the realm of the spirit. The daughter has become a brutal force in the realm of the spirit. A man of God was by the daughter within prayer. A man of God was now praying with the daughter. So where is this force coming from? That was the affliction that came upon the father. So the father was coming. The daughter did not know that the father was coming. But unfortunately for the man, it was on Tuesday, and that Tuesday was the day we were having our intercessory prayer. That was the day we were having our intercessory prayer. The father drove down. They drove the father down, and when they got to Benin, through their spiritual manipulation, oh come on, the father was able to locate the house of the daughter. But unfortunately, before they got to Benin, it was already time for prayer. So the daughter had left home and had come to church. So the father got to the house of the girl. The girl was not there. The daughter was not there. And so the father asked some question, and they referred the man to come to the church. The man did not fear. The man did not fear. The man headed to the church. The man headed to the church. Before the man came, our prayer have started. We were praying in the church. Suddenly, a vehicle drove into the church compound. I was right there on the altar. I could see everything that happened outside. And behold, the lady they were looking for, she was in the very front seat, opposite me. So I was praying. Now you see, we're leading prayer. Everybody was so a vehicle drove into the church. When the vehicle drove into the church, I thought it was one of those, you know, person that we come for prayer. But alas, I saw an emaciated, a reduced, beaten old man. He entered the church. Hiya. These people are desperate. Let me tell you, the enemy is so desperate. The enemy is so desperate to finish. Oh, come on. The father entered the church, and I saw the man when he entered the church right from where I was. I saw the man, you know, and when I looked at the man, I thought maybe one of those people that will come for prayer. But the man stood at the center of the entrance of the church and was using his eyes to look around. He was using his eyes to look for the daughter. The daughter was not even aware that that was the father. I was not even aware that that was her father. The man was using his eyes to look around. Spiritual connection, spiritual infrared, spiritual Zender, spiritual Bluetooth to connect, spiritual WhatsApp to connect, evil one to connect. And something just said that the daughter should look back. As soon as the daughter looked back, she was able to see the man and recognize the man. And the daughter bent down. The daughter just bent down and signaled me and said, "That man is my father." I said, "You don't mean it." He said, "Yes, my father, your father, your father, your father." I said, "Now, go round," and she went round and entered the sacristy and locked herself there. I said, "Don't come out until I knock on the door for you to come out. Don't ever come out." So she locked the door and she hid herself there. There was the spiritual Bluetooth of the father. The evil WhatsApp was trying to connect to know where the daughter was in the church. No fear. You brought the battle to my arena. You brought the battle to my battlefield. As soon as the daughter left, then I increased the prayer. "My father! My father!" Kabaya. And we went into prayer. Makabo Sage. I was not calling anybody's name, but we are praying. Everyone with evil intention, everyone with evil intention to kill and to destroy. "You shall die my death. You shall die my death. You shall die my death." Anyone that is here, any man, any woman with an evil intention to kill, any Goliath that has entered this place to kill and destroy, you cannot go back alive. You cannot go back alive. The whole church went into rage. The whole church went into prayer. The whole church went into warfare. Everywhere was tense with fire. Everywhere was tense with prayer. Everywhere was tense. And when the prayer was going on, I noticed the man walked out of the church. They parked their vehicle in front of the rectory, in front of the parish house. I noticed the man walk out of the church, and as the man was walking, I released another prayer point. Anyone digging the pit, they shall fall in it. So the church prayed earnestly. It was on the fifth prayer point that a man server ran into the church and said, "Father, Father, Father, there's a man, he's in front of your house, inside the vehicle. The man is dying. I tried to describe the man. Is it like this? They say, "Yes." Say, "The man is dying. He's already jerking, he's already shaking." Then I increased my own prayer. "My father, my father." You don't pamper Goliath. You hammer Goliath. You cut off their head. This ministry is a brutal ministry. If you dare, you go down. We hammer Goliath. And by the time we finish, the man has died in front of the parish house. Inside the car. The man died inside the car with his teeth clenched together like this. When I came out, the daughter was not even aware what has happened outside. When I got there, I saw the person died inside the car. I prophesy on you, every Goliath that said you will not live, they shall die your death. Any Goliath digging grave, they shall be buried in that grave. Any Goliath, I cut off their head. I cut off their head in the realm of the spirit. Goliath that will not let you have peace, I cut off their head in the realm of the spirit. Goliath that will not let you have peace, I cut off their head in the realm of the spirit. Goliath that will not let you have peace, I cut off their head in the realm of the spirit. Goliath that will not let you have peace, will not let your children have peace, I cut off their head. 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 I cut off their head in the realm of the spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When I got there, I don't know what happened. Something just told me, open the boot of the car. When I opened the, listen to me. You think I'm joking here? When I opened the boot of the car, that I don't know what even made me to say open the boot. When I opened the boot of the car that the man that they came with, what did I see? The man had come with various charms, various idols, various juju, different sizes was in the boot of the car. He drove that car into my compound. You cannot come there like that and go back alive. Because the ground, the ground is corrosive. The ground is saturated with blood, the blood of Jesus. You cannot come with that. You cannot come into that compound with that kind of thing and you expect to go back alive. You are joking. And I told the man that drove the vehicle, I said, you drove this vehicle here. You drove this vehicle here. You drove this vehicle here. So you came here with this charm. You came here with these idols. You drove this. You drove this vehicle here. The man began to, you know, deny that he never knew that there was such an idol. He never knew that there was such an idol. He never knew that there were such things. I said, how will you tell me that you are not aware that these were the idols you carried from your journey? You brought it to this place. How dare you? But the most shocking thing I saw among the idol was two carved human objects, a male and a female. Their back was torn together. I was tied with a rope. Their back was torn together like this. This is the man, this is the woman. Their back was torn together. I was tied with a rope. Oh, come on. Their back was torn together. That was the daughter. You will never see a man in your life. And that was the trouble of this lady. No man has ever approached her. No man, not knowing that her destiny, her life had been turned around. Her life had been turned around. You will not see any man. I took everything. I gathered everything. And I told them to bring this idol. They brought them and they put them beside near the grotto, and I set the idol on fire. I burnt everything. Oh, come on. I burnt everything to ashes. And when I finished burning, I gathered the ashes again. I put them in the cellophane. I went to keep it. And when they have all gone, I went to bury it somewhere. I dug the ground with holy water. I buried it. I told them, remove this man from here. Remove this man from here. They said, where? I said, remove this man from here. Remove this man from here, this evil man. Remove this man from here now. And that was how they removed the man, where they went to deposit him. That was when I now went to open the door, knock at the door, and the daughter came out and saw what happened. She was shaking. 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 As soon as the man was buried, the door opened for the daughter. Husband, as she was praying for all this while, husband came. I, Father Alfred, I did her wedding with the husband. What happened? The first issue she was to have, she gave birth to two boys. I'm telling you now, she gave birth to two boys. Look at the glory of the Lord was opened. A Goliath had been removed. She gave birth to two boys. To open her womb, God gave her two boys. Two boys was what she started with. I'm telling you now. So if you like, play with Goliath. If you like, you be showing mercy to Goliath. David has taught us how to handle Goliath. We cut off their head. Evil Goliath, we cut off their head. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let us begin to pray. Every Goliath standing on the land of my promise, are we ready to pray? Every Goliath standing on the land of my promise, be destroyed. Open your mouth and pray. Every Goliath standing in the land of my promise. Hey, go down, go down, go down. Every Goliath, you are standing in the land of my promise. You are standing in the land of my breakthrough. You are standing in the land of my rising. Every Goliath, I command you to go down. 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 Every Goliath, you are standing in the land of my promise. You are standing in the land of my rising. You are standing in the land of my lifting. You are standing in the land of my prosperity. What are you waiting for? Goliath, oh Goliath, I command you to go down. 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 I come at this midnight hour to address the matter of that Goliath, that obstacle, that mountain, that barricade. I command you to go down. 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 go down. Every Goliath, every Goliath, you are standing in the land of my promise. How dare you? I command you to go down. I command you to go down. I command you to go down. Open your mouth and address your Goliath. Goliath is a mountain. Goliath is a problem. If you don't address your Goliath, it will reproach you and mock your destiny. Open your mouth and pray. Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath in the land of my promise. Every Goliath that will not let me be. Every Goliath that will not let my marriage be. Every Goliath that will not let my children be. Expire by fire. Expire. Expire by fire. Expire by fire. Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath standing in the land of my promise. Every Goliath, hey, that is thirsty for blood in my family. Every Goliath that is thirsty for blood in my family, you die our death. 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 Every Goliath that is thirsty for the blood of my family member, that is thirsty for the blood of my children, expire by fire. 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 Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath, you are thirsty for blood and my family is your target. You expire by fire. You expire by fire. You expire by fire. Open your mouth and fire prayer. Let us handle Goliath once and for all. That nonsense must stop. That nonsense of that Goliath must stop. We got to stop it. If not that David came to stop Goliath, he would have held Israel for so long a time. He has reproached Israel enough, and everyone was afraid. You cannot be alive and be afraid. And Goliath is reigning in wickedness. Somebody must confront. Somebody must fight to deliver and liberate the entire family. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. Makali babose, regede mado, shikarondo, mandelede, rabaki badonde, rabaki badonde, rabaki badonde, rabaki badonde, ligabosa kadea, libabosa kadea. Every Goliath that is thirsty for blood within the ambit of my family, every Goliath that is thirsty for blood around my children, every Goliath that is after my case, every Goliath that is after my case, every Goliath that is after my gate, I hear the report of God. Expire by fire. 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 I say expire. 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 Every Goliath that is after my case, every Goliath in the land of my promise, expire by fire. Expire by fire, expire by fire, expire by fire, expire by fire. Fire of God fall upon you now. Fire of God fall upon you now. Fire of God fall upon you now. Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath that is after my family, every Goliath that has made a vow that my family will not stand, that my family will not move forward, every Goliath that is holding my family down, your time has come. Expire by fire, expire by fire. Your time has come, your time has come, your time has come. Expire by fire, expire by fire, expire by fire. Goliath, oh Goliath, I cut off your head, 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 I cut off your head. Goliath, bury my family, Goliath, bury my children, Goliath, bury my ministry. I cut off your head, 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 I cut off your head. Open your mouth and fire prayer. I cut off your head. Makobu Satonde. I cut off your head. Let me tell you, read your Bible. It was when David, oh come on. The Bible says David had the head of Goliath, because David cut off the head of Goliath. And David had the head. And it was when David had the head of Goliath, coming from that battle. That was when women rushed out. People rushed out. And they began to sing a new song. Because David has killed Goliath. Hear me. There are new songs that you need to sing. But you cannot sing the song because Goliath is there. You need to sing a new song in your marriage. You need to sing a new song in your health. You need to sing a new song in your life. You need to sing a new song in your finances. You need to sing a new song in your family. But you can't sing a new song because Goliath is there. Goliath resists the song of Israel. The women that came out couldn't sing when Goliath was alive. But they were only able to sing when Goliath fell. There are new songs in your mouth, but you cannot sing it because Goliath is still alive. We are going to pray. Every Goliath fighting my new song. Hey, yeah. Today, every Goliath fighting my new song. Say, my father, as I pray, every Goliath fighting my new song. 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 Expire by fire. Expire by fire. Expire by fire. The judgment of God is upon you. The fire of God is upon you. The vengeance of God is upon you. Every Goliath fighting my new song. Every Goliath fighting my new song. Open your mouth and pray. Every Goliath fighting my new song. Every Goliath fighting my new song. Makade lege parosateya. Every Goliath fighting my new song. You are fighting my new song. You are holding my new song. Expire by fire. Expire by fire. Expire by fire. Go down. Go down. Go down. Go down. Go down. Open your mouth and fire prayer. Goliath are not pampered. They are hammered. You don't romance with Goliath. You put fire on them. David did not speak retreats. David did not speak gently. When he approached Goliath, he said, "I will cut off your head." David was not quiet when Goliath was raging hell against Israel. He said, "I will give your body to the beast of the forest." Open your mouth and pray. Goliath fighting my new song. Goliath fighting my new song. I cannot sing in my marriage. I cannot sing in my family. My life is just in one spot. Every Goliath, go down. Go down by fire. 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 Every Goliath, go down. Now let's pray. Goliath from my father's house. Goliath from my mother's house. Goliath from my family background. Goliath in my marital background. In my marital place. Goliath, Goliath. Matana, patana, marita. Hey, patana, matana, marita. Every Goliath is from my patana side, from my matana side, from my marita ground. Go down, go down, go down, go down, go down, go down. I say go down, I say go down, I say go down, I say go down, go down. Fire prayer. Fire prayer. We don't play with Goliath. A father had a daughter. A father had a daughter. Had the daughter down. You don't play with Goliath. And what was it that David said? What was it that David said when he saw what Goliath was doing? He said, "Who is this useless Philistine that is reproaching the army of the Lord?" Hey, yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Who is this useless Philistines that is reproaching the army of the Lord? So, what is it that Goliath does? He will reproach you. What is reproaching you? What is Kabo Sakade, Liba Sutayonde, Magade Zida, Legebo Sukaronde, Lago Sayenda? What is reproaching you? What is reproaching you? Hey, come on. What is reproaching you? When the presence of Goliath will reproach you. A lot of people are reproached. They don't know what to do with their Goliath. I am telling you, this is how we handle Goliath. It is not face to face. No, we wrestle not with flesh and blood. It is through prayer. For in everything by prayer, in everything by prayer. How dare that wicked demonic uncle still raging and holding the family down? You are just looking. Somebody must fight hard. Somebody must fight hard. Somebody must liberate the family. Somebody must liberate the daughters of the house. Somebody must liberate the family from ancestral bondage. Cannot be quiet. And death is raging. Raging from one quarter. Raging from one quarter. It's a Goliath. Every Goliath. Declare with me. Every Goliath. Thirsty for blood. Hey, yeah. Every Goliath. Thirsty for blood. I pray you shall drink your blood. You shall drink your own blood. Every Goliath thirsty for blood. Every Goliath thirsty for blood. Every Goliath thirsty for blood. Within my family, within my household. Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath thirsty for blood. You shall drink your own 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 blood. Every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath within the ambit of my family, within the ambit of my life, hear the report of God. You shall drink your own blood. You are thirsty for blood in my family. You are thirsty for my blood. You are thirsty for the blood of my members online. You are thirsty for the blood of my ministry members. You shall drink your own blood. 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 Every Goliath, you are thirsty for blood. The blood of all my members, all my sons and daughters in ministry. Hey, you shall drink your own blood. Hey, you shall drink your own blood. Goliath, oh Goliath, you shall drink your own blood. 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 Hey, you shall drink your own blood. How dare you? You don't dare the cub of a lion, and the lion is looking at you. You don't touch the cub of a lioness, and the lioness is looking at you. He said, I am the lion of the tribe of Judah. You cannot dare my members. You cannot dare my members. Hey, Goliath, hear the report of God at the middle of this night. You cannot dare my members. Everyone who has become a member of this ministry, you cannot dare them. They are untouchable. They are unkillable. They are unkillable. They are untouchable. Every Goliath thirsty for blood, thirsty for blood, they shall drink their own blood. They shall drink their own blood. They are thirsty for blood within your family. They are thirsty for blood in your office. They are thirsty for blood in your marriage. Goliath thirsty for blood. Goliath thirsty for blood. Goliath thirsty for blood. Drink your own 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 blood. I said drink your own blood. I said drink your own blood. Goliath thirsty for blood. Goliath thirsty for blood. Goliath thirsty for blood. I said drink your own blood in the name of Jesus. Drink your own blood. Oh, come on. You dare my members. You are holding them down. You shall drink your own blood. Tonight. Goliath, oh Goliath, your head is separated from your body. Your head is amputated from your body. Your head is decapitated from your body. Your head is cut off from your body. Makabo sakade, ligabo sukarone. How dare that Goliath? You cannot allow Goliath to reign supreme. You cannot allow Goliath to reign strong. Hey, come on, somebody must have to stand. David stood and Goliath went down. We are going to pray. My father, Makabo Sukade, Ligabo Sandea, Ligabo Sandea, Ligabo Sandea. My father, as I pray, I stand on behalf of my family. Goliath, oh Goliath, go down, go down. Can you not pray? Listen, I cannot imagine now somebody is sleeping. Or you are praying like this, you are dozing. I pity you now. Because I'm not playing now at all. If you play with Goliath, I pity your life. Because it's not all the time we come and we just, this is Goliath matter. That is withstanding your destiny, you are looking. That has held your family down, you are looking. You cannot fold your hand when the matter borders on Goliath. You fight with your life. You fight in the spirit. The Bible says, fight a good fight of faith. This is a good fight of faith. This is a good fight of faith. This is a good fight of faith. You cannot fold your hand and your family, they are dying. Members of your family, they are dying one by one. You cannot fold your hand. You cannot be looking. You cannot fold your hand. You cannot fold your hand. Yes, if they die, they will go to heaven. But we have to fight. Let them fulfill their purpose on earth. Let them fulfill their purpose on earth. You cannot cut short my life. Goliath cut short people's life. So we cannot be looking. So we're going to pray. My father, my father. My father, my father, as I pray, I stand in the gap of my family. I stand on behalf of my family. I stand in intercession for my family. And I pray, Goliath, oh Goliath, what are you still standing for? Die by fire. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Goliath of David died by the catapult. Our own, we die by fire. We die by fire. Goliath, oh Goliath, die by fire. My father, my father. My father, my father. My father, my father, as I pray, I stand in the gap of my family. I stand on behalf of my family. I stand in the gap of intercession for my family liberation. Goliath, oh Goliath, why are you still standing? Die by fire, 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 die by fire. Die by fire, die by fire, die by fire, die by fire, fire prayer. You cannot fold your hand and you are burying members of your family. You cannot be looking. That brain of that juju have read enough. The power of Goliath, we are withdrawing it today. We are withdrawing it today. We are withdrawing it today. We are withdrawing the power and the audacity of Goliath to stand before your family. Die by fire. Die by fire. By fire. Goliath, go down. Goliath, go down. Oh, Goliath, go down. Goliath, go down. Goliath, go down. Who is that wicked, wicked satanic personality? Who is that wicked satanic personality that killed your father because of bride price? Who is that wicked satanic personality that have put sickness in your husband's body because of property in the village? You are looking like that. You are just folding your hand. Come on, ever since the time of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence. It is the violence that take it by force. You are taking back your husband by force. You are taking back your head by force. Who is that Goliath that is burying charm? Who is that Goliath that is going to native doctors? Who is that Goliath that is raising evil altar? Who is that Goliath that is raising evil altar? Altar, oh altar of Goliath, catch fire, 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 catch fire. Kite fire, kite fire, kite fire, altar, oh altar, altar of Goliath, kite fire, kite fire, kite fire, kite fire, kite fire, kite fire, altar, oh altar, kite fire. Who is that Goliath that is moving from one herbalist to another? Who is that Goliath that is moving from one herbalist to another? Both the herbalist and the herbalista. Both the herbalist and the herbalista. Both the herbalist and the herbalista. Don't look at the English. We are praying. Both the herbalist and the herbalista. You go down. You go down. You go down. You go down. You dare my children. You go down. You dare my members. You go down. You dare my family. You go down. You dare my house. You go down. You dare my house. You go down. You dare my house. You go down. Fire prayer. Oh, come on. Israel was reproached. Israel was reproached. And nobody, even the king, could not do anything. You are looking at Goliath ravaging every member of your family. You are looking at Goliath. He has sown the seed of poverty. Nobody is standing. Nobody is doing well. How dare you fold your hand? How dare you stand and look? How long will you stand and look for the reign of Goliath to go ahead? Goliath started day one, day two. The Bible says for 40 days, for 40 days, the Bible says for 40 days, Goliath held Israel. For 40 days, Goliath held Israel. He started from day one. Nobody stopped him. Day two, nobody stopped him. Day three, nobody stopped him. Anything you don't dare to stop will continue as affliction. I'm talking to somebody here. We are dealing with spiritual matters. Goliath started from day one. Goliath started from day one. Then day two, day three, day four, day five. For 40 days. For 40 days, Goliath held Israel in reproach. Anything you did not dare to stop will continue as affliction. Anything you, if David has not come on day 40, it would have entered day 41, day 42, day 43, day 44, and continue like that. Anything you don't dare to stop, anything you are folding your hand, it will continue as an affliction. Anything you don't dare to stop, anything you are looking at, you are just saying, oh, I don't know, I don't know, I don't know, I just tired. No, you don't get tired for Goliath matter. You become brutal. You become terrific. You become dogged the spirit. You take your armor. You don't get tired when it comes to Goliath. Anything you don't dare to stop, any affliction you don't dare to stop, any reproach you don't dare to stop, we continue until you stop it. You fold your hand. You are looking at Goliath. Members of the families are just down. No one has, they don't even know where Lagos is. Why is the family living like this? Because a Goliath has vowed that, I know of a family, when you marry, you will come back. When a daughter marry, after a while, she will come back. Because a Goliath has vowed ancestral power, have sacrificed their daughters that they will not leave their family house. But it was a silent thing. You will get married, then you will come back. You will get married, then you will come back. You will get married, then you will come back. It was power, ancestral power, that was speaking retrogression, speaking back to square one, until it was discovered through warfare. That's why, look, let me tell you, I believe in silent prayer. I meditate a lot. Look, I meditate a lot. When I read my scripture, I take out time to meditate. When I pray my rosary, Pope John Paul said the fruit of the beads of the rosary, the fruit of the mysteries of the rosary is in meditation. If you read the apostolic letter of Pope John Paul II on the rosary and the Blessed Virgin Mary, when he was talking about the mysteries of the rosary, he said the heart of the rosary is in the meditation. So I meditate in silence. I meditate sometimes a whole day. I can be so silent in brutal meditation. Hey, but my dear, Hey, my dear, everything is not all about meditation. There is a time you shout like Jesus before the grave. Kabo, makabade. There's a time you shout like Jesus before the grave of Lazarus, who have been buried for 4 days. Destinies have been buried. You are keeping quiet. Destinies is inside the grave. You are keeping quiet. But Jesus did not keep quiet. When he came face to face with destiny that was buried, when he came face to face, even a stone was used to cover the grave of Lazarus. Jesus said, remove the stone. And they removed the stone. He looked at the grave. He saw a destiny buried. He saw a destiny on the ground. He saw a destiny tied with white cloth. He saw a destiny. A destiny was on the ground. And the Bible says, Jesus gave a loud cry. He gave a loud cry. He gave a loud cry. Let nobody deceive you that you are praying and you are praying aloud. There's a time to be quiet. Pray silent prayer. But there's a time to makabo sataye ligado sude kade. You dare my family by mistake, you die by correction. If not, look, they will use your life like suya. You dare my family by mistake, you die by correction. So let nobody deceive you and tell you you are not praying well. Why are you praying? You just pray. Why are you praying? Because they are not wearing your shoe. Because they are not burying a member of their family before. That's why they are talking like this. Because affliction have not reigned supreme in their life. That's why they are talking like this. They are being in their comfort zone. They think life is all about enjoying the comfort zone. There is something called the battleground. There is something called the battleground. That was where David won. David did not win in the comfort zone. David won in the battleground. It was after winning in the battleground that the throne was given to him. We are going to pray. You see, it was after David killed Goliath that the throne was given to him. We are going to pray. Every Goliath preventing me from possessing my throne. Oh, come on. Come on. If somebody cannot pray here today, I will be so disappointed. Every Goliath preventing me from possessing my throne. Every Goliath preventing me from possessing my throne. Every Goliath, Kabo, Ligado, Zade, Makade, Marebo, Suka. Every Goliath that is fighting me from that is preventing me from possessing my throne. As I pray, go down, go down, go down. I declare your grave open. I declare your grave open. I declare your grave open. Goliath fighting me and preventing me from possessing my throne. And preventing me. I declare your grave open. 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 I declare that at the midnight hour of my prayer, every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath, every Goliath fighting my inheritance, preventing me from possessing my throne, preventing my shining. Every Goliath preventing my shining. I declare your grave open. 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 I say go down. 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 Fire prayer. You are looking at Goliath reigning supreme out there. I say go down. I say go down. I say go down. Oh, I say go down. Oh, you cannot remain like this. You will not remain like this. Marriage, 10 years, no child. Marriage, 10 years, no child. Marriage, 12 years, no child. Marriage, 7 years, no child. Come on. Makabo sukaye, ligabo sakadeya, mandirabo sukayonde. I speak on behalf of somebody. Every Goliath fighting your marriage, you don't stay alive, oh, you die by fire. every Goliath fighting your marriage, every Goliath fighting your marriage, every Goliath fighting your marriage, every Goliath fighting your marriage. I declare their grave open. Thank you, Jesus. David could not possess the throne until Goliath fell. David was not able to come on. He was a man of the bush. All this while, he was a man of the bush. But that was not his place. He needed the throne. He needed the throne. Until Goliath fell, David never entered the palace. When Goliath fell, Saul said, "Who is this boy?" And Joab said, Abner said, "He is the son of your servant, the Bethlehemite." He's the son of your servant, the Bethlehemite. From the house of Jesse. As soon as Goliath went down, the house of Jesse was recognized. Every Goliath fighting my recognition. Come on, let us pray. Every Goliath fighting my recognition. It was when Goliath fell that the house of Jesse was recognized. Saul said, "Who is this man? Hey, where did it come from?" Say this. Look at it here. Verse 58. He said, and Saul said to him, "Whose son are you, young man? Whose son are you?" So David answered, "I am the son of your servant Jesse, the Bethlehemite." I am the son. The house of David was recognized by force. The house of David was recognized by force. If your prayer life is not tough with fire, if your prayer life is not sorted with fire, rubbish will perch on you. I have never seen anything that perch on fire. They only perch on cold objects. Your spiritual life cannot be cold. Your spiritual life cannot be cold. You are too casual. Many of us are too casual. A casual Christian become Christian casualties. Many of us are too casual. You are too casual. Too casual and too cold. Nothing perch on fire, but they perch on cold things. Sickness will perch on you. Failure will perch on you. Barrenness will perch on you. Disappointment will perch on you. The nonsense of life will perch on you. Why? Because you are too cold and you are too casual. Nothing perch on a hot object. If you touch it, you remove your hand because the thing is hot. Nothing perch on fire. You cannot make it. Come on. Your life is too cold. That's why Goliath is raining. Your life is too casual. Casual Christians becomes Christian casualties. I thank God you are able to follow me this 21 midnight. If you can go through 21 midnight, your Christian life cannot be casual. And if your Christian life is not casual, you cannot be a Christian casualties. Thank you, Jesus. Look at it here. Recognition was. Let me read it to you. Verse 57. Look at verse 57. From the passage we read from, and that is 1 Samuel chapter 17, look at verse 57. It says, Then as David returned from the slaughter, you don't pamper Goliath, you slaughter them. Look at it here. Some of us, you oversabi too much. Now you know God pass. Now you know church pass. When it comes to Goliath, you slaughter. Look at it here. Then, as David returned from the slaughter of the Philistines, that is the language, from the slaughter, from the slaughter. When David returned from the slaughter of the Philistines, Abner, look at it, Abner took him and brought him before David. See, Abner took him and brought him before David. Who is Abner now? A helper. You are not assessing the presence of a noble king. Why? Because you have done great things. Look at it. Abner took him. Oh, we are going to pray this prayer point. Come on. See, my head is hitting. Abner took him in his hand. Abner took him and brought him before Saul with the head of the Philistines in his hand. The head of Goliath was in David's hand. Listen to me. The head of Goliath, David cut off his head. So the head of Goliath was in the hand of David. Look at it here. With the head of the Philistines in his hand. When Saul saw David, he said, "Whose son is this one? Who born this pekin? Whose son?" Recognition, 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 recognition came by force. You are not recognized. That's why, because you have allowed your Goliath. When you kill a Goliath, recognition, a Goliath fell. A lady that had never known a man, no man has ever come into his life, got married that year. The following year, she gave birth to twins to start. You cannot sing a new song when Goliath is there. Look at it here. He heard the head of the Philistines. He heard the head. He heard the head of the Philistines. And immediately Saul said, "Whose son is this one? Eh? Whose son is this one?" So let us take a prayer point now. And what is the prayer point? My Father, as I pray. Oh, come on. My Father, as I pray, as I bring down my Goliath, release my Abner. Who was Abner to David here? He was the one that paved the way for David to come into the presence of Saul. You see now, Abner became a helper to David. My Father, as I pray to bring down my Goliath, release my Abner. Release my Abner. Release my Abner. Hiya. Hiya, ya. Hiya, ya. Hiya, ya. My Father and my God, my Father, as I pray for my Goliath to go down, as I pray for my Goliath to go down, as I bring down my Goliath, yes, say it like that, my Father, as I bring down my Goliath, as I bring down my Goliath, as I bring down my Goliath, release my Abner, Abner, will not take you to the presence of the general. Abner is your helper. Abner will pave the way for you. Abner will take you to your zenith point. Abner discussed with the king face to face. But David couldn't assess the king. But when David killed Goliath, it was Abner that appeared and took David down and brought him before King Saul. So my Father, as I pray, As I bring down my Goliath, release my Abner, Makabo, Ligabo, Sakade, Legede, as my Goliath go down, release my Abner, as my Goliath go down at the middle of the night, release my Abner, release my Abner, as my Goliath go down, release my Abner. Abner, locate me now. Release my Abner. And how was Abner released? When David heard the head of Goliath in his hand. You can never be popular if you don't hammer Goliath. Family will never be liberated if you don't hammer Goliath. Family will never know any peace if you don't hammer Goliath. You will see your children in one spot because you have allowed Goliath to reign supreme. You are looking, you better stand in the gap and liberate members of your household. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Makali babo, legede bado zide, liago sakaya. Thank you, Abba Father. Recognition was given to David, the house of Jesse. Whose son is this? How? The head of Goliath was in the hand of David. As my Goliath goes down, as my Goliath goes down, Father, release my Abner. Father, release my Abner. Father, release my Abner. Oh, come on. Release my Abner. Release my Abner. Oh, Abner. Oh, Abner. Locate me by fire. So, you see, Abner can only locate David through warfare because David was coming from the war. Listen, listen. You see the way we are praying now. We are Catholics. But you see the way we are praying now. Some people don't like it at all. Listen to me. You see the way we are praying now. Hey! Listen, you see the way we are praying now. Some people don't like it at all. You know what? We don't owe them any explanation at all. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey, so you expect me as father to be quiet? My members are dying. To be quiet. My members are on the ground. To be quiet. My members don't make progress. To be quiet. My members don't have breakthroughs. To be quiet. My daughters cannot marry. You expect me as father to be cool with that? You are not well at all. I don't owe you. Eh? So what is my priesthood all about? To drink tea after mass. Eh? To drink tea. And to watch home video. To watch Nigerian movie. That is what my priesthood is. You know well at all. I should be comfortable. My daughters are, they are not married. I should be comfortable. I should be comfortable. Things are not working for families. I should be comfortable. Sickness are killing my members. I should be comfortable. I should not do anything. After mass, I drink tea. I drive a very nice car. And everybody say, Father, Father, that is what I want. You are joking. You are joking. The priesthood is warfare. The priesthood is warfare. The priesthood is warfare. There is the priestly and there is the prophetic and there is the kingly. Don't zero me to the priestly alone. There is the prophetic. And prophetic goes with fire. Ask Elisha and Elijah, they will tell you. The prophetic goes with fire. So I know where I belong. I should be very comfortable. I should be okay with the affliction of my people. I should be fine with the affliction of my people. I should be comfortable. I'm just fine. I'm just fine. Then they transfer me to a big parish. I am just okay. You are joking. The priesthood is all about big parish. It's all about the salvation and the deliverance of souls from the clutches of satanic wickedness. It's not just about all about being transferred to big parish. Come on, come on. So we don't owe you at all. So if you don't like the way we are praying, please leave the platform. Hey, go. We see. I didn't beg you to join my platform now. Now I didn't beg you now. You are the one that used your hand to like. So unlike yourself out of the platform because we don't owe you. But can I shock you? What the prayer you think you are seeing now, we are in the Kidaganti. We are coming. We don't start prayer. We never start. What you are seeing now is the KG1 of our prayer. There is the secondary school. There is the university. There is the postgraduate. There is the master. There is the PhD. There is the professorate of our prayer. We are just beginning. If you don't like the way we are praying, we don't owe you. And if you don't like the way we are praying, we don't owe you any apology. Just leave the platform. Because you see this kind of prayer, I die here. You see this kind of prayer, makaboshukade lebosadeya. I died here. I'll go and sit down. And you want to corner me and put me in your cooler. Your cooler cannot size me. I'm bigger than your cooler. Your cooler cannot size me. I am bigger than your cooler. You want everybody to be like you. No, I can't be like you. Because there is a diversity of gifts. I explained that here before. And we are all heading to one kingdom. You should be grateful for what our ministry is doing for the kingdom. You should be grateful. You should be grateful for what our ministry. Look at all of us now. Awake. In a normal situation, who will be awake like this? Look, we are all awake. Look at the time. Till 2 in the morning, we are all awake. Is it playing now? We are praying. This is all what my ministry is all about. We are praying so that nonsense must stop. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey! Come on, let us pray. Every Goliath threatening my progress. My father, as I pray, every Goliath threatening my progress, threatening my rising, threatening my greatness, receive the visitation of fire. Open your mouth, receive the visitation of fire. Every Goliath, threatening my progress. Every Goliath, threatening my children's progress. Every Goliath in my children's school, in my children's school. Who is the Goliath that is fighting my children? Every Goliath in my children's life. Hey, receive the visitation of fire. 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 Every Goliath, receive the visitation of fire. Every Goliath. Makabo, Ligado, Sigadebe, Rabo, Sakaye, Ligadon de Sagoya, every Goliath that is threatening my progress, that is threatening my rising, that is threatening my family, receive the visitation of fire, 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 receive the visitation of fire. Thank you, Jesus. Come to even think of itself. Let us come to a boutique of it. The other spiritual style of your own prayer that you think you know how to pray. We even pray and pass you. If you come to Marian devotion, we die here. We even marry and pass you. So relax. Don't argue what you know you cannot handle. Even when it comes to the Marian devotion, are you more Marian than us? Let June, let May come, let October come. Are you more Marian than us? Makabo Shaka. Let me enjoy this music for a while. Makali Badone. Heya. Let us enjoy this music. Makali Babo Sakadea. Goliath cannot stand. Maga baba ba, laga degede. Liga babo sakade. Liga bonde, rabade legede. Legebo sakoya. Maga debo sede. Liga bonde, rabade lege. Rakade basia. Goliath cannot stand. Maga libabo sade. Goya. Thank you, Jesus. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Mandele bosu kalibo sandeya. Holy Ghost. Hey. Thank you, Jesus. Hey. Sites benedi siyo. Makaliba bosu kade. Forward and making progress. Hallelujah. Let us take one prayer point more before I prophesy on you. Makabo sukaronde. Heya. Tomorrow is day 20. What we have here, breaking the yoke of barrenness. You cannot stand a barrenness race breaking the yoke of barrenness. Look at it here, day 20. You get it. Breaking the yoke of barrenness. That's what we have for day 22. Breaking the yoke of barrenness. Come on. Let us take one prayer quick more. Makabo Sakade. Let us take this last prayer point. He says, Father, by your anointing, David was endowed to fight and defeat Goliath. By your anointing, let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Open your mouth and pray. Father, by your anointing, let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Father, by your anointing, let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Father, by your anointing, let me be established in victory. Let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Let me be established in victory over my Goliath. Father, by your anointing, open your mouth and fire prayer. Father, by your anointing, establish me in victory over my Goliath. Establish me in victory. Open your mouth and pray. Father, by your anointing. David was anointed before he confronted Goliath. Father, by your anointing, let me be established in victory over every Goliath. By your anointing, open your mouth and pray. By your anointing, establish me in victory, establish me in victory. By your anointing, Lord, establish me in victory over my Goliath. Father, by your anointing. Establish me in victory. Establish me in victory. Establish me in victory. Father, by your anointing, establish me in victory over my Goliath. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. By your anointing, Lord, establish me in victory over Goliath. Ligabo sakade bakidaronde legedebo sakadoye ligabo sakadayade mandele dede mandele dede. When David killed Goliath, he was lifted to the throne. So I will be prophesying on you now prophetic blessings for your supernatural lifting 2021. Prophetic blessings for your supernatural lifting for 2021. And before I begin to prophesy, click on the share button. Let us go. Makabo Sakade. See, I cannot imagine you not sharing this video today. Because we need to help somebody that is experiencing terrible grip of Goliath. So I give you 1 minute. Let's go. Click on the share button right now. Share, share, share. If you have shared before, share again. Thank you, Jesus. If you have shared before, share again. Thank you, Abba Father. What was the contention before? When Father Alfred, parishioners are just leaving their church. They will go to Father Alfred's church. They will go to now. Parishioner does not even need to come to Father Alfred's church again. I minister to you at the comfort of your room. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Inside you, are you in my church now? In the comfort of your room, I minister to you. In your living room, in your bedroom, I minister to you. Now the rage has improved and enlarged. It is now a global venture. We are even calling it CIPM International. No, very soon. It's going to be CIPM Universe. Look at you. In my day, in my or say Salopari or in my yeki. Very soon shall be CIPM Universe. We are only in international. We are coming. Very soon. CIPM Universe. We are coming. You relax. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, I minister to you at the comfort of your room. There's nothing like when I was not going home, they now waylaid me and took my phone. They now waylaid me and took my car. Hell, honey, hero, I minister to you at the very comfort of your room. We are just CIPM International. We are coming. CIPM Universe. Do you know how many countries are here? Do you know how many countries now that how many countries are live here? If you want me to prove it, let just type your country. Do you know how many countries are live here? You think we are joking here? How many countries are here? When I was doing it in the church, now we are now universe. CIPM Universe. Yeah, you think we are joking here? What will keep me awake by this time every day for 21 midnight November? We did 21 midnight. I entered December again, January again, enter 21 midnight. You think I am just there and playing? We are talking of rescuing destinies and changing satanic purpose. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 I want to believe that you are clicking the share button. Yes, CIPM Universe, we are coming. Look at it, America, look at, just let me know the country you are in. We are already there now. We have somebody, look at America. In fact, America, don't we have a branch in America, in Plano, Texas? We have a branch there. Look at the countries, various. Use 1 minute to type the country that you are in. Let's look, Nigeria. Nigeria, headquarters. Nigeria. God bless you, Nigeria. Look at, people are awake this night. You think we are playing here? You are only thinking of your own. Poland. Look at it, Poland. All the way from Poland is awake this night. Poland is awake this night. Just type your country. That's all. Let people know where we are going. USA. Look at it. We are playing. Think we are playing. All those of you in USA, I just congratulate you for your new president. CIPM Universe, we are coming. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Look at them. America. Yes. America. Look at everybody. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Macabo. See, America. Germany. Look at Germany, Spain. Look at people. My mates are my members now. These are my, you think I will fold my hand? Spain will not bless you. America will not bless you. Poland will not bless you. Nigeria will not bless you. The devil is a bastard. You are joking. Look at it. Maryland, America. Look at it. And then I will fold my hand. See, Spain, I'm watching for Spain. Nigeria, look at people. Yes, look at people all over. Look at people. So you are Atlanta, Georgia. I should fold my hand. You see, Canada. Look at them. All over the world. I should fold my hand. Then the country that people are in will not be blessed. You are joking. Look at people. See, we have people from Dubai. We have people from Trinidad and Tobago. We have people from Australia. We have people from, come on, look at them. Yes, USA. We have people from Turkey. We have people there. They follow us on this platform. Think we what will that keep me awake for 21 midnight? Awake. My sleeping schedule have changed. I now sleep in the day. I awake in the night. Italy, look at it. Italy is there. Asian city of Benin, Edonobaye is there. We are watching from Paris. Look at them. They're there. Detroit, Michigan. Look at it. I'm watching from Michigan, from Detroit. I was in Detroit in 2006 and 2007. See, Columbus, Ohio. I was in Ohio 2 years ago. Look at it. Columbus, Ohio. Look at it here, UK. UK was in UK 2 years ago. Look at them. UK, Houston, Texas. I was there 6 months. I was there last year. Look at it. Dallas, Texas. I was there 6 months ago. Look at the world global. This is CIPM Universe. Then you think I will not fold my hand? Then it don't concern me. Your daughter is facing problem in the office, facing a racial problem, racism. They want to finish your daughter, and you have a priest. I am folding my hand. Oh, that is a mistake. I can't fold my hand. That is a mistake. North Carolina. Look, Michigan. These are people who you devote your time. Watching for Canada. Thank you, Jesus. Watching from UK. Think we are playing here from Chicago. Look at it, from Chicago. From Chicago, from Lagos. Thank you, Jesus. Just let us relax. Don't worry. So that some people will not go and have hypertension. Just relax. Minnesota. Relax. I'm watching from Ibadan. See, somebody from Accra, Ghana. Somebody is watching from Accra by this time. Somebody is watching from fully awake from Lagos, from London. People are awake. This is prayer. This is prayer. It don't do so that people will not go and have heart attack. Father, we are watching from UK. UK, we bless you. We are watching from Zimbabwe. See, journey from Cross River, Calabar. Journey from, can I prophesy on you? I prophesy in the name of Jesus, in the place you are right now, in the country, see, watching from South Africa, in the place you are right now, in the country you are right now, somebody watching from Kaduna, in the place you are, in the country you are, that ground we bless you, that country we bless you. I prophesy as your father, I prophesy as your man of God, in the place where you are, where you are domiciled, right now, this middle of the night, I prophesy that ground will bless you. That ground will bless you. That country will bless you. That country will bless you. That ground will bless you. Receive in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Receive. You are blessed. You shall become the envy, envy of that nation. People shall look at you and recognize the grace I put upon you right now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Ancient of Days. Oh, Father, we give you all the glory. We give you all the glory. Makabo shakade. Ligidibo sukaronde. Ligidibo sukaronde. Ligidibo sukaronde. Magabo sakadeya. Bangabu babo shade. Legede sakoteya. Libababo sade. That country you are in, that land you are in, that country you are, that state, Africa, Europe, Germany, that continent you are in, I prophesy that land will bless you. 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 I said that land will bless you. I said that land will bless you. I release this blessing on you. At the middle of this night, no one can curse you. Thank you, Jesus. Let me prophesy on you before we can call it a day. Thank you, Abba Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey! Thank you, Jesus. Roda Igariva, I didn't see you for Atlanta. Julia Igbide, I can see you. North Carolina people, I can see you. Boston, Massachusetts, I can see you. Osawese, oh. Let me prophesy on you. Thank you, Jesus. I stretch forth my hands on you. Now, receive this before we go. Thank you, Abba Father. I stretch forth my hand on you and I prophesy. Oh, come on. I stretch forth my hand on you. Makabo sukade legedebo mandorebo seya. I stretch forth my hands on you. And I prophesy. Look, it is all about supernatural lifting. 2021. Supernatural lifting. Supernatural lifting. 2021. Immediately Goliath went down. David ascends the throne. Immediately Goliath went down. David ascends the throne. He was lifted. Abner came out from nowhere and became the helper of David. Abner brought David before Saul. I stretch forth my hand and I speak prophetically over your life. In the name of Jesus, God, my God, the lifter of head, we lift you up and change your story. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. As your Goliath goes down, God is lifting your head. God is lifting your head. God is lifting your head and changing your story. God is lifting your head and changing your story. God is lifting your head. Makabade, rabado, legede, ligabo. Hey! God is lifting your head and changing your story. Thank you, Jesus. Like Jabez, you shall experience the supernatural lifting of God as the Lord hears your prayer. Makabo sakadeya. Suddenly, your coast shall be enlarged. Suddenly, your coast shall grow. Suddenly, your coast shall improve. Suddenly, your coast shall expound. Thank you, Jesus. Your sudden lifting shall be a marvel and a surprise to many. I prophesy on you, your sudden lifting, your sudden lifting, your sudden lifting shall be a surprise and a marvel. Your sudden lifting, your sudden lifting shall, I prophesy, it shall be a surprise and a marvel to many. By God's supernatural lifting upon your life, I prophesy, by God's supernatural lifting upon your life, you shall experience a glorious turnaround. You shall, Mabo Sade, you shall experience a glorious turnaround. You shall experience a glorious turnaround. You shall experience a glorious turnaround. I decree and I declare in the name of Jesus, you shall experience a glorious turnaround. You shall experience a glorious turnaround. You shall experience a glorious turnaround. Thank you, Jesus. You shall operate in the fullness of God's blessings. I prophesy by the lifting of God upon your life. You shall operate in the fullness of God's blessings. You shall operate in the fullness of God's blessings. You shall operate in the fullness of God's blessings. You shall gain the acceptance and the recognition of people of your generation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When Goliath fell, David gained the acceptance and the recognition of the people of Israel. I prophesy in the name of Jesus, you shall gain the acceptance. Your family shall gain the acceptance. Your children shall gain the acceptance and the recognition of the people of your generation. You shall gain the acceptance of people. You shall gain the recognition of people. Your supernatural lifting, Kabo, Ligabo, Sade, your supernatural lifting shall be a source of influence and encouragement to those around you. A source of influence, a source of influence, a source of influence, and a source of encouragement to those around you. I prophesy in the name of the Lord Jesus that you are changing levels. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You are changing levels. You are changing levels. And things are turning around for your good. I stretch forth my hand and I prophesy on you. You are changing levels. You are changing levels. You are changing levels. And things are turning around for your good. You shall receive sudden promotion that will make you relevant to your world. Hallelujah. 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 You shall receive sudden promotion. You shall receive sudden promotion that will make you relevant to your world. That will make you relevant to your world. The supernatural lifting that will make you command the attention of your generation is resting upon you. The supernatural lifting that will make you command the attention of your generation, the attention of your generation, it is resting upon you. It is resting upon you. The supernatural lifting that will make you command the attention of your generation, hey, it is resting upon you. In the name of Jesus, you shall become the commander of great wealth and property. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I prophesy, you shall become the commander of great wealth. You shall become the commander of great wealth and properties. You shall become the commander of great wealth and properties. I prophesy on you, you shall become the commander of great wealth and properties in the name of Jesus. Your lifting shall position you to be in charge. Hey, your lifting shall position you to be in charge, to be in charge, to be in charge. To rule and to reign like Joseph. To rule and to reign like Joseph. You cannot be lifted and don't rule and reign. Thank you, Jesus. I prophesy on you in the name of the Lord Jesus that the glory of the Lord shall be seen rising over you. The glory of the Lord shall be seen rising over you. The glory of the Lord. I prophesy it upon you in the name of Jesus. Attracting kings and those that matters. Yes, that glory will attract kings and those that matters. They will come to you. God's supernatural lifting upon you shall make you rise and shine. Shall make you arise and shine. Shall make you rise and shine. It shall put you in front of others who started out ahead of you. It shall put you in front of others who started out ahead of you. I prophesy on you in the name of the Lord Jesus that you shall experience an all-round lifting. All-round lifting. You shall know all-round lifting. Oh, come on. All-round lifting in the name of Jesus. You shall occupy the position you did not lobby for. Hallelujah. 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 You shall occupy the position you did not lobby for. You shall occupy the position you did not lobby for. Hear me? You shall occupy. You shall occupy. You shall occupy the position you did not lobby for. You shall enjoy privileges you did not beg for. You shall enjoy privileges you did not beg for. Somebody receive it this night. You shall enjoy privileges you did not beg for. You shall possess materials and great assets you did not labor for. Thank you, Jesus. By God's supernatural lifting upon you, by God's supernatural lifting upon you, all those who have ever looked down on you will be humbled to look up to you. They shall be humbled to look up to you. They shall be humbled to look up to you. Thank you, Jesus. They shall know what it is like when the hand of God is at work. They shall know what it is like when the hand of God is at work. I prophesy in the name of the Lord Jesus that you will not use your lifting to extort or to oppress the less fortunate one, but rather you shall be a blessing by lifting up others who are down. Shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing. You shall be a blessing by lifting up others who are down. Thank you, Jesus. You shall become a shoulder and a voice to the voiceless in the society. You shall become a shoulder and a voice to the voiceless in the society. Your generation shall know your relevance. Hallelujah. Your generation shall know your relevance. Your generation shall know your relevance. Your generation shall know your relevance. Hear me. Your generation shall know your relevance by the supernatural lifting of God upon your life. Hallelujah. 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 Hey. I am blessed. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit of God. I am so blessed today. Come on. Come on. Come on. I am so blessed today. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. For tomorrow, you are going to read 1 Samuel chapter 1. For tomorrow, wow. 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 See, you are going to read the whole of 1 Samuel chapter 1. Listen to me. For tomorrow, you are going to read the whole of 1 Samuel chapter 1. Then, you will enter chapter 2. Then, 1 to 21. The whole of 1 Samuel chapter 1, you will read it. Then, you will enter chapter 2. You will begin from verse 1 and you will end in verse 21. So, that is the readings for tomorrow. Amen. I want to encourage you to be a blessing. A blessing to the less fortunate one, the orphans. God will bless you. So if you are here to bless the orphans in this platform, you have to do that because it is part of the rules that govern our fasting and prayer. So you can put a message on my WhatsApp asking for the account details for the orphans. Or Mr. Henry, we put the account details online. But if you cannot get the account details online, you can ask me, and God will bless you. Please, God gave me a word that delivers somebody with terminal infirmity, and that word came from Psalm chapter 41, beginning from verse 1 to 3. And what we have there, blessed is he who considers the poor. When you consider the poor, the Lord will bless you. Yes, when you consider the poor, when you consider the poor, the Lord will bless you. The Lord will deliver him in the day of trouble. Do you want the Lord to deliver you? Do you want the Lord to deliver you? Take a special offering. Donate to the less privileged. The Lord will protect him and keep him alive. Hear me? The Lord will protect him and keep him alive. You want to be alive? You want to stay alive? The Lord will protect him and keep him alive. He is called blessed in the land. You shall be called blessed in the land. Just consider the orphans. Thou will not give him up to the will of his enemy. God will not give you up to the will of your enemies. Look at it here. These are the blessings when you consider the orphans. The Lord will sustain him on his sick bed. On his sick bed. The Lord will sustain him on his sick bed. And in the last place said, in his illness, thou shalt heal all his infirmities. Thou healest all his infirmities. The Lord will heal all your infirmities. The Lord will look at it here. Please send something to this. Consider the orphan. We do the word of God, not just hearing it at all. We do it. You have to do it. So make sure you consider the orphans and God will bless you. Yes. We are planning so many things for the orphans. We are getting the mattresses. You know, we are getting mattresses. I have not been giving a formal report how what it costs. And we will share it with everybody here by the grace of God. And we are Orphans eat every day. Orphans eat every day. So partner with us on that regard. And God will bless you. Now, a brother of ours, let me tell you, a brother of ours paid for the data that we are using since last year. You see, the data actually was supposed to expire in the month of March. But because we have had series of program every day, so the data is expiring very soon. And it paid for 1 year. So the data is expiring very soon. So I will appeal to stay on online. We need data because the house is not wired with an internet. We use a router. We use a router, and I can use 20,000 naira a month. So that brother paid, like he paid for the whole year. And that year that our brother paid for supposed to expire soon. Yes, very soon. But it's not like that now, because it has been every day. So we have used a lot of data. So God will bless you if you put that in your mind. Yeah, God will bless you. Most of the time I can spend 20,000 naira for a month. And that's why when I pay that, I can come online anytime. I make sure I use it. Who is celebrating birthday? I can see happy birthday, dear. Who is celebrating birthday that for that friend is not aware? Can somebody tell me who is celebrating birthday? Okay, happy birthday, Yvonne. Is it Yvonne or more Caro I know, or another Yvonne? Who is celebrating birthday? Let me know. Let me speak a word over you. Who is celebrating birthday? Happy birthday, Yvonne. More grace. Happy birthday, my sister. Who is celebrating birthday? Okay, let me speak a word of blessing over Yvonne. I saw happy birthday, Yvonne. Yvonne, I bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus. As you celebrate your birthday today, Yvonne, you shall live to see many days. Your days will never be cut short. Your days will never be few. Yvonne, I bless you. Yvonne, I bless you. Yvonne, I bless you. Your life will be a testimony and the envy of your world. Hallelujah. Oh, I bless you, I bless you, I bless you. Testimony shall abound in your life. And this new age that you clock, God will give you a turnaround and a change of levels in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oluchi Okeke is 10 today. God bless you, Oluchi Okeke, and God bless you, Yvonne. In the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All these blessings are blessing you on your birthday. You people should better keep my cake, oh. You better keep my cake. I'm telling you now. You better keep my cake. Yeah. It is well with you, my dear. So that is it. So I will encourage you to do that. So most times I buy data for 20,000 and it serves me. I can come online multiple times and I make sure I use it. Then because I never had it in mind that I will have 21 days. In a year, we may have up to 5 21 days. 21 days fasting and prayer is almost gone. Very soon, we are going to begin 21 days baptism of, 21 days festival of favor. 21 days festival of favor. When we are done, we are going to begin 21 days baptism of prayer. When we are done, we come and do 21 days midnight warfare. See, there are 21 days, every day. And it is data. So whatever you can give for to support ministry for data, God will bless you. Makabo Sakade. Father Alfred loves you dearly. Don't forget. Somebody's asking, Father Alfred, when is your birthday? Father Alfred, when is your birthday, please? My birthday is March 14th. On the 14th day of March. In fact, that day fell on Sunday. Now I die be that day. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Please don't fall prey to any scammer. They are everywhere. Don't fall prey at all. God will judge every scammer that try to impersonate me. God will judge them by fire. God will judge them by fire. So don't fall to any scammer. No. Don't pay to any account. Don't pay to any account in Kaduna or in Kogi. No, don't pay to any account in Kaduna or in Kogi. No, these are the activities of scammer. They want to scam people, and as you see, God will fight for you, and God will disgrace every scammer. So please, don't fall for any scammer. They will tell you that there's an orphanage. You call the empty of the orphanage. Don't call any empty. They are all scammers. Yeah, they are all scammers. So God be help you. God be fight for you. God be give you victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. God will give you victory. You are going about with fake accounts. Yes, fake accounts. Fake accounts. And so don't send any money. Clear from Father Alfred. Yes, clear. Send a WhatsApp message. And I will reply you. I will send you the account details. Yes, I will send you the account details. It is well with you. Father Alfred loves you. Hallelujah. We don't have much time. We don't have much time. For by the next 2 days, we should be rounding up. So tomorrow is day 20 now. Breaking the yoke of barrenness. And the last day is Thanksgiving Day. Thanksgiving that further opens the door. So just be part of it until we finish. And God will bless you. It is well with you. It is well with all that concerns you. Father Alfred loves you dearly. Great grace and favor. Great grace and blessings. For all those that sent their money for names for the register of dwelling in his presence. I am still transferring names. And you will get report from me. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. Those of us in America, happy celebration for the newly inaugurated administration of Joe Biden. We pray that God be giving wisdom to rule that great country. He's well with you. Stay blessed. Father Alfred loves you.